you too. What's good, Shibu? Everything water and water is everything, my familia. I got for you guys a crazy freeze hunter stasis PvP build. I'm telling you, this is crazy. The Scarlet potential is insane. I personally feel like it's one of the best top three pulse rifles in the game right now. I don't even have it enhanced. And I don't even have it enhanced. It's insane. It shreds. And then when using a mask, a Baccarus, this is also going to be enhancing the Scarlet potential. But let's get into the video, man. But yeah, starting off with this video, we're going to be starting off with the exotic mask of Baccarus. Now, this exotic got a buff last couple seasons where now this the perk of this exotic is replacing your status stasis subclass dodge ability with a longer range, faster shift that potentially cloaks you during use. After shifting, your stasis and arc weapon deal increased damage for a short time. Now, so basically, because we're going to be using a certain weapon we're going to talk about a little bit later, this is going to make that weapon so much better. And not only that, with one of the aspects we're going to be using now with a dodge, we're freezing enemies. This is going to be really good for going in close to certain enemies and just dodging out the way, freezing them. And also, you're basically invisible for those first like 2 or 3 seconds, and it's farther, it gets you out of enemies' way. Obviously, if you don't do it in time or your reaction time is slow, you can get hit. But without that, honestly, you can get yourself out of so much like damage in PvP. Like if somebody's throwing a grenade and you need to get out, boom, you go ahead and slide out. Or if somebody's really close to you, boom, you slide out and you freeze them. Now they can't move, or they moving a lot slower. So that's really good for that. But yeah, so now we're gonna be getting to our weapon. Now we don't have an exotic weapon, but we got something that's really insane. We got this scalar potential. This pulse rifle is so insane. Now the handling is a little wonky, but if you can get this enhanced, I'm telling you, I don't even have this enhanced. My perks is Enlightened Action and Golden Tricon. That's all my perks, and those are really good perks, but you can get enhanced version, buffing it even more. This shreds, and with the mask of Baccarus, you shred enemies. You're gonna see in the video, I literally shred, and I really mean shred. Like, some of these games, I was doing so good with this weapon, I got booted off. Like, I got booted off, I'm so serious. It was a full game of just destroying. I'm gonna show you guys the clip of destroying them. I'm telling you, it's insane. This is top three best pulse rifles in the game, and I'm being honest. But now we're gonna get into the full build, the aspects and the fragments of what we're gonna be using for this PvP build. All right, starting off for our super, we're gonna be using Silence and Squill. That's the main super we have. For our ability dodge, we're gonna be using Marksman Dodge. You wanna be able to reload your weapon while dodging, which is pretty cool. Cause you know, we're using the Baccarus, the headpiece, the mask of Baccarus. So we're gonna be sliding and freezing people. So reloading your weapon is gonna be good with that. Obviously, we're gonna be using Withering Blade. Now for our grenade, the best grenade to use for hunters is Dust Field Grenade. It's really good. You'll be able to slow enemies down longer too, which is cool. We're gonna be using Touch of Winter, cause we know Dusk of Grenade increases our in size and has a small crystal shield that helps us regenerate our grenade. We're also going to be using Winter Shroud. We're not using Shatterer Dive or Grim Harvest because we're going to be able to dodge and slow by nearby targets just in case you're in front of a player. You want to be able to dodge and also freeze them while reloading your weapon if already being used and they just come closer. So that's really good to use. And then starting off with our fragments, we're going to be using Whisper of Conduction, Nearby Stasis Shards, Tracker, Precision. This is just a boost to resilience and intellect for me. That's why I really have it. And then we're going to be using Winter of Chains. While you are near frozen targets or nearby stasis crystal, you take reduced damage from targets, which is pretty cool. Again, this is mostly just for adding recovery to max out my recovery. As you guys can see, it's at 100. Also using Whisper of Durance, slow that you apply to targets last longer for abilities that linger, their duration will also increase. This is really, really good because now this is applies to our dodge. This also applies to our dust field grenade, and this also applies to we already said our dodge. So basically also our Withering Blade that also freezes enemies too. So that's really good. This is one that I would say you should have, a mandatory one when you're using PvP.
And also we got defeating slow or frozen target grants you ability charge, energy. So that's also good. These are the two main ones you should have. Everything else is just depending on what your stats are looking like, in my opinion. But the main two you should have for PvP is Whisper of Durance and Whisper of Refraction. Now, we're going to be talking about our artifacts. Honestly, this PvP artifacts don't really mean anything crazy. So whatever you want, you can have. It doesn't really matter. Now, going to our weaponry and stats, these are important. You want to max out your mobility to get your dodge, and a dodge is going to be the main aspect of this, because not only does you're going to be dodging, it's also going to be buffing your scalar potential. So you want to be able to do that. So you want to get max mobility. You want to get your dodge as much as possible. And then you want to have max recovery. You want to regenerate your health as much as possible. So when an enemy does get you low, you can move out the way and run and still be able to regenerate your health pretty quick. Discipline at a 60, pretty good. And intellect at a 58. Let me see. I can't. If you can get your discipline, your intellect to a 60 and discipline a little bit higher, that's fine. Resilience is fine. Strength doesn't really matter. I don't really care for strength as a hunter. Resilience, maybe if you have three times, tier three resilience is pretty good, but tier two for me is fine. But yeah, most important is just mobility and recovery. And then for weaponry, I'm gonna be using the Astral Horizon. This is really good. I got slide shot and I got one two punch, which is really good. I do have the adept version, but it's not a good roll, so that's a bummer. And obviously the scalar, and I'm also using the unwavering duty. This is just really good for just cleanup crew, like when you get heavy, because when you use a rocket you only get like one, so this you get you like 32 bullets, so you can really take out between maybe like 2 to 3 enemies with this instead of just one, which is really cool. But yeah, that's it for this build, man. If y'all like this build, please do a like and subscribe. It's your boy, Everything Water and Water is Everything, my familia. And we out.